What are the real differences between a normal child in a classroom and a dyscalculic child in a classroom?
As we said, the dyscalculic children don't have much sense of number, and their sense of number is very ones based. They see number four as the number that comes after three, but again, they're lacking this number sense. They don't see patterns in numbers, connections between them.
How do dyscalculics do maths then? I mean, how?
They tend to do everything by counting in ones.
Right.
So if you ask them what is 2 and 3, they might actually say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they haven't got a sense that if they know 2 and 2 is 4, then 2 and 3 must be 1 more. So they tend to just go back to counting in ones.
So that sounds like they could just about cope with the absolute basic arithmetic, but anything multiplication or division would surely be very difficult if you're just using ones.
Yes, because they don't really get the concept of multiplication.
Right.
So, for example, they get very confused when you say, how many groups of three can you see on the table? They can't get the idea that you can have one group. You've mentioned the word one, but they can see three items in that group. So it takes a lot of practice to get the idea that multiplication is counting in groups. Often when I meet children, people ask, how do you get a sense that they're dyscalculic so quickly? And sometimes it can be really obvious. I saw one little boy, and I asked him how many fingers he had on one hand. And he counted in ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. And then I said, and so what about your other hand? And so, much to my astonishment, he started counting the fingers on his other hand. So he wasn't absolutely sure that he had the same number of fingers on each hand. And then I said, what about the feet? I was fascinated to know whether he knew about his feet. No, he started to take his socks off and to count his toes. And again, he wasn't convinced that he had 5 toes on one foot and 5 on the other. Never mind that they had that made 10 altogether.
So in a way, it seems like there's no kind of I don't want to use the word common sense, but there's no basic confidence in numbers. So,
well, no. The ironic thing, a bit like dyslexia, is some of these children can be very clever about everything else.
Yeah.
And they may have brilliant common sense, and they might be very streetwise. And still, it seems like a dream when suddenly there's this black hole in their understanding of something so fundamental. After all, our ancestors used their body parts to count, even their elbows and their shoulder when they ran out of fingers. And yet these children don't have a sense of even their own bodies.
So Jane, dyscalculia seems such a fundamental disability that surely it must cause massive anxiety amongst the children and correspondingly their parents as a result. Do you agree?
I do, yes. I think one of the major effects is that anxiety builds up and self-esteem goes down. And these children often sit in classrooms not really understanding very much at all. And so they sit waiting for help. They develop learned helplessness because they genuinely don't know where to start. And especially if they're given lots of options of how to do this, that and the other, they just want to be told exactly what to do and to try and do it. They often can't understand what the teacher says. And then the class moves on and they're left behind. And they can't really learn from their peers because their peers speak so quickly and they don't understand or remember.
And their peers seem to have got it, presumably.
Yes, and then they feel terrible when all their friends have understood what's going on and they so obviously hadn't. And then they begin to cover up, of course. So they go and sharpen their pencil rather a lot. And they can even become disruptive and become the class clown merely as a way to get attention and to survive and to wriggle out of actually having to face the maths. So it is very important to help them as soon as possible.